I will speak about application reflection equation algebra, what is, to my opinion, two matrix models. Just a moment. The first question, what is quantum analogon, the Villotin algebra of the Lie algebra G? Everybody easily answer this question. Of course, quantum group of Drinfeld, Jimba, UQG. However, for the particular case of GLN and SLN, there exists another quantum analog on the Villotin algebra. It is a so-called modified reflection equation algebra, or its quotient. So now I will explain what do I mean by reflection equation algebra. Let R be a Hecke symmetry coming from quantum group. Recall that by a Hecke symmetry, we mean a braiding. It means an operator R acting on the space V squared in the same space, subject to the braid relation. It is well known. And Hecke symmetry is particular case of the braiding subject to the relation presented here. It is just as follows. Q is generic, and Y is identity operator or a matrix. The Hecke symmetry coming from the quantum group equal, if I choose a group in the space V. In the space V squared, the basis is as follows. And so I present my operator by a matrix, and with matrix is as follows. You see that as Q goes to one, with Hecke symmetry tends to the flip, usual flip, matrix of the usual flip. However, if dimension is greater than two, there are other Hecke symmetry tending to the usual flip. For instance, Kramer-Gervais Hecke symmetry. It's difficult to present explicitly with symmetry, but they are. Now, the mentioned above, the modified reflection equation algebra is generated by the unit is the entries of the matrix larger, subject to the system, with system. So here R is, for example, matrix presented above. After that, M1 and so on and so on. What is M1? As usual, M1 is M tensorated with identity. We're not with algebra L. And if we consider a similar system, it is system because we have here matrix relations, so many relations. If we consider this system without right-hand side, we have zero here. It is called non-modified reflection equation algebra. I want to say it's very important property that if I replace here in this relation on this one, R by the usual flip P, we get respectively the enveloping algebra. It is matrix presentation of the envelope of GLN. Or commutative algebra. If you put here P, you have just the algebra with commutative. If in the above relation, we replace the Hecke symmetry R by superflip PMN, it is more or less usual notation. We get the enveloping algebra here, this algebra of super algebra, and super commutative algebra, symmetric algebra of that, super commutative. Okay, now I want to consider an example related to the algebra as follows. So the corresponding matrix R is Hecke symmetry presented above. And now M1 is 4 by 4 matrix as follows. So if you put all the matrices in the relations defining the modified reflection equation algebra, in this algebra, we have this system. It is just an example corresponding to this algebra in general. But you see, if Q goes to 1, we have such relation in the enveloping algebra. So we have AB minus BA is equal to B, and so on, and so on. It is just this relation. Okay. I want to remind you that there exists another quantum matrix algebra. Quantum matrix means that we present the relation is with algebra by matrix. There exists another algebra called RTT algebra or Leningrad algebra. So I don't want to speak about this algebra. I want only to say that it is not deformation of the enveloping algebra. It is only deformation of symmetric algebra, GL2. But if we impose with relation more determinant, Q determinant in some sense, and I want to speak about that, is equal to 1, we have deformation of function algebra, polynomial algebra of SL2. So if we want to deform with algebra on the group, it's possible to have with algebra RTT and reflection equation algebra as well. But if we want to deform enveloping algebra, it is possible to use reflection equation algebra in modified form, modified reflection equation algebra. So because we are interested in analog of the algebra, we deal with modified reflection equation algebra and not with RTT algebra. Okay. I would like to present now modified reflection equation algebra in a form similar to enveloping algebra. So it's possible to present modified reflection equation algebra as follows. It is one generator, tensor, another one, minus some operator applied to these two elements, and a linear combination here, some linear combination. But if I denote with linear combination as usual, as a bracket of two elements, so we have operator R acting in the space M squared in the same space M. It is a space, linear space, vector space generated by MY. So we have with operator and bracket. And so we call is object. What object? Object, the vector space with operator and the bracket. It is analog on the usual rebracket JLM. Now, what is a version of Jacobi identity? Here, it is more interesting, difficult. One of this version says that if we define action of an element on another one as follows by means of this bracket on the previous page. So we define a representation. Namely, we apply Y to Z, after that X to Z, after that we transpose N set Y by using R, we apply two times, it is equal to that. So it looks like the usual Jacobi identity. But instead of supertransposition or flip, usual flip, we have here R. Okay, now this data is called generalized braided algebra and is denoted GL V, the space V, equipped with R, with a Hecke symmetry R. This algebra have been introduced by myself for R involutive, and myself with Pyatov and Saponov for Hecke R. For Hecke R, it is more interesting, of course. And if we take as R Birman Wellman Murakami Wenzel symmetry coming from quantum group of other classical series. It's possible to introduce this object, no problem, but it is not a good deformation on classical object. For Hecke symmetry, it is. With this reason why I am interested in Hecke situation and not Birman Murakami Wenzel. Okay, now I want to introduce some operator introduced by Lubashenko. He is present now in our conference, I guess. So operators B and C, some operator, they can be constructed by means of R, but it's difficult to explain. But finally, we have to operate a band B and C. And what is why I am interested in this operator? Because if I define action of the generator MYG on an element of the space V as follows by means of operator B, so we have a representation. Why operator C is useful? Because if we consider the following trace of product M here is any matrix, and C is just this operator, we have an analog of the trace. And it is trace, I call it R trace, coordinated with our initial Hecke symmetry R. Hecke or involutive symmetry R. This operator turns into the classical one if R goes to its usual flip. Super one if R go to super flipper. So in this situation, C becomes identity and trace becomes the usual trace. Here similar. Okay, now it's possible to introduce a finally here I try to explain that it is a structure and endomorphism of the space V. So what is endomorphism of the space V in the category? All spaces are finite dimension. So this is the product as follows. And finally, it's possible to, by using the operator B and B to introduce coupling or pairing between element of the space V and element of the dual space. If I consider in the dual space the right dual basis, it means that it is defined as usual. With pairing is just delta. But if we want to pair, to apply pairing between element in another sense, in another order, it's necessary to use B. So what is difference with classical situation? In classical situation, if we have here delta, we have delta here as well. In the general situation, it is not so. Okay, now I would like to mention a property that is very useful for matrix model. Modified reflection equation algebra is in principle isomorphic to non-modified reflection equation algebra if we have the following change of the matrix. It's very useful property, but it is not valid if Q is goes to one. You know that symmetric algebra of GLN, it is not isomorphic to enveloping algebra of GLN. So if R is involutive, it is not so. But if R is Hecke, it is so. Now, I want to introduce in my algebra generated by the matrix M an analog of elementary symmetric polynomials and full symmetric polynomials. It is just a definition. What is definition? So it's necessary to put here A on OS. It is an analog of Q symmetrizer. Here we have symmetrizer, and here some product of the matrix M, one over line, and so on. Here I explain what is notation of indices over line. But finally, doesn't matter, it's possible. I resume, it's possible to introduce an ELEC of elementary and full symmetric polynomial. It's possible to introduce an ELEC of sure polynomials as well. For them, an ELEC of Litterwood-Richardson rule is valid as well. Quantum power sums are defined as follows. So difference with classical situation in the following one. The usual trace is replaced by A trace, the only difference. Okay, now we have an ELEC of Newton and Vronsky relation. So you see the difference is that Q comes here with the relations for Hecke situation. For involutive situation, Q disappears, becomes one. Okay, now, more interesting, of course, is Kelly-Hamilton identity. In order to present it, I want to introduce, consider special partition. Lambda, it is partition. Partition was discussed in the previous talk. Partition corresponding to the following diagram. So you see, we have here a rectangle, here one column, and one line row. So I denote with a partition or with diagram in the following way. And zero, if we have zero here, I omit with indices. Here's symbol. Okay, now we say that involutive for Hecke symmetry R is of type Mn. If rectangle, here we add one here as well, is the smallest rectangle such that the sure polynomial we have the following following partition here is equal to zero. It is trivial. It is not evident that they exist the smallest rectangle, but it's possible to show it. So they exist smallest rectangle possessing this property. And Kelly-Hamilton identity in a factorized form, if R is of Mn type, has the following form. So I present here just Kelly-Hamilton identity. I would like to say it's very important property for us that coefficient here and here are central. They belongs to the center of reflection equation algebra. I want to say that this property, this relation is valid in non-modified reflection equation algebra, but by using isomorphism mentioned above, I can obtain a similar relation in modified reflection equation algebra. Okay, now let's introduce now mu y and u nu y. They are eigenvalues of the first factor and they are eigenvalues of the second factor, which means that Kelly-Hamilton polynomial can be presented under the following form. So this is the first coefficient squared, after that the main coefficient. After that, with factorization of the first product, and here the second. Okay, now I would like to mention here a result by Khudaverdyan and Voronov that they have shown that for super matrices, the ratio of two sure polynomials as follows, and the following one equals to Berezinian. So for us, it is more reasonable definition of Bayesian, because we have here one central element, here another central element. So Bayesian is a ratio of two central elements. In our setting, much more general, we have a similar definition. By definition, just this ratio is called Bayesian. And it is presented as follows. It is product of mu, product of nu, some coefficient here. But it's possible also to define an ELOH of determinant. You see, Bayesian determinant is two different elements in our algebra. It is a ratio of a Schur polynomial corresponding to this partition and here this one. So we have here product of mu and product of mu. Here, ratio of product of mu. And here, product of numerical factor. Okay. Now, it is interesting to express Schur polynomial. Here, any Schur polynomial. Why give it? For instance, if lambda is non-trivial rectangle MN, then we have the following expression. So some non-commutative combinatoric with polynomial is supersymmetric. What does that mean, supersymmetric? By definition, if we have two sets, XY and YJ, independent commutative variables, a polynomial P is said to be supersymmetric if it's symmetric with respect to X, symmetric with respect to Y, and upon substitute, if we put X1 is equal Y1 is equal to T, the resultant polynomial does not depend on T. Now, parameterization. I presented some parameterization, some symmetric polynomials. But now I put the same question for powers. What is parameterization of powers up? Parameterization is as follows. So it is usual formula, classical formula, is valid if we put here one and here. Here, minus one. We have just a classical formula. These coefficients are called quantum dimension. But in general, for any mu and u, the formula are as follows. I would like to say that with polynomials, are close to whole little wood ones, are similar, looks like. So now I repeat, if we put u equal one, we retrieve here the classical formula. But classical for super matrices. So now, if we pass by using that modified or non-modified form of Reflection Equation isomorphic, we want to get similar formula for general situation. For modified Reflection Equation algebra, we get the following formula. So this formula is similar, but formula for quantum dimension, a little bit different. You see here Q minus one, here Q, that's on it. So only the quantum dimension are changed. As we put Q is equal to one, we get a parameterization for generalization matrix on the Villopian algebra as follows. I want to say once more that the relation in the Villopian algebra of the super algebra GLMN is as follows. Okay. Now, I want to say that finally, if we consider modified reflection equation algebra corresponding to Hecke symmetry coming from the quantum group, we have in principle two parameter deformation of this commutative algebra. One parameter, it is just a passage to enveloping algebra. It is, as you wish, corresponds to Lie bracket, to linear bracket. And another parameter comes from passing to reflection equation algebra. So we have two parameter deformation. So we have the Poisson counterpart, which is generated by two bracket, linear bracket and quadratic bracket. And so finally, Poisson counterpart is pencil. And an analog of the second bracket sometimes is called Semyonov-Tyshansky bracket. But Semyonov-Tyshansky bracket for me, it is rather bracket defined on the group. And we are dealing with the algebra. Another interesting remark. There is a very interesting result by Scheuchert. Scheuchert shows that if we have a unimodular Poisson bracket, unimodular means that there is a measure compatible in length with the bracket. And if we have such Poisson bracket, it can be quantized by using, for example, Kontsevich method, but it's possible to quantize so that finally we have an algebra with the usual trace, with trace on the quantum algebra. While the quantization with the trace is possible if we have a unimodular bracket. But the bracket related to reflection equation algebra is not unimodular. It is not possible to construct the corresponding measure. Such a measure doesn't exist. As you see, I presented a trace in quantum algebra, but this trace is deformed. It is not classical. It is not usual. So I want to compare my construction with a Scheuchert result. If we have unimodular situation, with usual trace is possible. If we have my situation, it is not possible, but the trace is possible in principle after quantization, but it is difficult. Now, I pass to matrix model. We consider the simplest one matrix molded defined by the following partition function. Usual situation. V is a polynomial. If lambda are eigenvalues of the matrix H, it is of course a matrix, we consider integration of the set of matrix. We can present with a partition function over via eigenvalues as follows. So what is here result? Result here is that in this situation, we have the measure dH is just Vandermonde determinant square. It is just specific for Hermitian situation. For other classical situation, we have here one or four. I consider a Hermitian model. Okay, so what is my idea since long ago? I would like to quantize this model. So quantize means that I want to define an analog of the partition function. Possible to do. It is very tempting to replace the usual trace by a trace. Now, instead of I write down L. Assuming L to be generated matrix of modified reflection equation algebra corresponding to a involute for Hecke symmetry. All terms coming in this classical situation should be replaced by the above ourselves, parameterized via eigenvalue mu and nu presented above. But what is the analog of the measure? It is not evident at all. So consider the following matrix. Here you see all traces are addresses, braided traces. Consider the following matrix. Proposition. If I consider the classical case, classical means that I is usual flip, m equal n and n is zero. So determinant, usual determinant of this matrix is just or that among the determinant square, depending on. Finally, I omit the potential V dependent on H, and we arrive to the following formula. As we take determinant, usual determinant of this matrix as analog of Vandermonde determinant general situation. So we arrive at the following formula. And now we expressed our generalized matrix model or braided matrix model via eigenvalues mu and nu. You see, now finally, instead of the classical Vandermonde determinant, we have the following expression. Now, I want to discuss one question more. The following question. We consider only finite dimensional situation and consequences of this consideration for matrix model. But how is it possible to pass to infinite dimension situation? So I will present two ways how we can construct some analog in infinite dimension situation. So for that, we consider analog of general of Young matrices of I call it Young braiding, depending on parameter current braiding. Current means that we consider here parameter. Our braiding now depends on parameter. And here we have just the usual Young braiding, current braiding. But if we apply Baxterization procedure, we have the following proposition. If R is involutive symmetry, then the following braiding here we is a current braiding. It means that it meets the current braided relation. It is braiding relation as well as above, but now we have with relation with parameter. If R is Hecke symmetry depending on Q, so then we have a similar statement, but now R is given by the following formula. Okay, we introduce with my co-author Pavel Saponov the generalized Youngians of RTT type. You see, this relation is similar to relation in RTT algebra. Now only the only difference, now the matrix T depend on parameter and the braiding R depend on two parameters as well. And generalized Youngians of reflection equation type. You see, here the difference is inside. This relation looks like a relation in reflection equation algebra. It is also possible to construct double Youngian-like algebra inspired of Reshetykin Semyonov approach. But I want to discuss a little bit more another approach to construct infinite dimensional structure arising from affinization. So we have now a generalized Lie algebra denoted as follows. I define this algebra above. It is modified reflection equation algebra. So with a notation here, it is not good, but it is enveloping algebra of generalized algebra. Okay. And what is affinization? We take the generalized matrix, initial matrix, and we consider a series of the corresponding matrix depending on u per number k. As usual, this affinization applied in the usual way. So now it's necessary to introduce, to define the enveloping algebra of generated by with matrices. Okay, the relation is classical, more or less classical, classical in quotation marks, of course. We have here R hat, where R hat, it is R above, but of course it's necessary to interchange the number K and number L. So we interchange here. And here we have an L term. So it's very natural. So it is not possible to define Schwinger's term in another way. It is a very natural way. So we have product, after that we apply an Erlich of trace, and so on and so on. So as you wish, we obtained a fine algebra, but with algebra is braided. Okay, but the problem, I discovered with algebra with my colleague some years ago, but finally recently we understood that with algebra is not good. I will explain why. So finally we considered with algebra as a U and Erlich of the enveloping algebra of the affine GLN. But question, very interesting for me, whether it's possible to construct quantum an Erlich of tau function in this way. I would like to mention paper by Morozov and all on QT deformation of Gaussian model. In this paper, they said that tau function was not constructed. It is what was 2018. But with attempt to construct such a quantum tau function has been undertaken by Kharchev and Taza in this year. So before that. And finally, the attempt failed. It is not so easy to do. And I thought maybe our algebra was good for constructing quantum an Erlich of tau function. Why? Because if we consider QT models in sense of Morozov and Toll, we have the relation with this algebra more or less as follows, plus minus means that we have fermions or bosons, it depends. But the relation are more or less classical. Here, we have something depending on Q and T. So Q and T come in only coefficient here of linear terms. And if we want to construct a real quantum an Erlich of tau function, it's necessary to have the following relation. So Q here and Q here is absent in the approach. So now I consider our algebra, but I repeat, whether it's possible to construct Q model by using our algebra in order to fall in a fine algebra. Unfortunately, if the initial R is Hecke, our affine algebra is not deformation of the classical affine algebra with this problem. And consequently, our affine algebra is not good. However, if R is involutive, our affine algebra is good. It is not strongly proven, but it seems Hopefully it is so. So if we want to construct a reasonable Q vertex algebra via affinization, it's necessary to deal with an involutive symmetry, with this problem. And such a involutive symmetry, what is page now? Involutive symmetry as follows. This symmetry is involutive. You can check it, it's very easy. It is a symmetry braiding. So the braiding relation is fulfilled. And it's possible to consider the corresponding algebra, modified reflection equation algebra, and construct a fine analog of that. So in this situation, this algebra is a good deformation. And I don't want to go into detail concerning construction of the corresponding quantum vertex algebra. I want only to say that the ordered product of two fields, N and B, must be defined as follows. You see, it is more or less classical way to define ordered product, but here, instead of the Suter flipper, it's necessary to put our flip, hat. But of course, it's necessary to take initial operator A, initial symmetry to be involutive. It's very important. And if we do so, so it's possible to develop a whole theory concerning vertex algebra, and so on, and so on, and so on. Everything goes smoothly. And finally, it's possible to construct the corresponding field theory as you wish. But it is only the beginning of the story. It is just in progress. It is not yet constructed, but it's possible. But in this connection, I finish in 2 minutes. I want to mention quantum analog of vertex algebra introduced by Ettinghoff-Kasdan. It is object algebra constructed via double Q Hengians. Finally, it is in the spirit of Rishitikin, Semyonov, Tenshansky approach. So we have Q Hengian, as we discussed above, dual Q Hengian, which is constructed in a similar manner, and finally, some relation between two Hengians. And relation between two Hengians, or permutation relation, are introduced in the spirit on the paper Rishitikin, Semyonov, Tenshansky, if I don't, if not mistaken, 1892. But finally, axiomatic description of quantum vertex algebra introduced by Ettinghoff-Kasdan is very, very hard. If you want to understand what object do you have really in this situation, you have something like looking like double Q Hengian. And our Q analog of vertex algebra is more easily to understand. And they are in some sense more natural. So I stop here. I only want only to resume in 2 words. Finally, you see our approach concerning matrix model based on reflection equation algebra in just in progress, the only beginning of the story. But the other part, constructing on infinite dimensional algebra, braided infinite dimensional algebra, so it's necessary to apply either the first method described above, so analog of Hengian, or second method described above, or affinization of the, and I think that affinization is much more interesting, but it is only the beginning of story. I stop here.
Okay, thank you very much. Now it's time for questions or remarks. Even comment. So we thank the speaker virtually, and it is the end of the day.